We're going underwater. Look at this. We're in Alabama. We're gonna go in the tunnel now. Going in the tunnel with the RV, and we're hoping that it's RV friendly. What if it gets stuck?
It's the tunnel of love. We can't get stuck.
We just went to Love's and got gas. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
That's two Love's today.
That's a lot of love.
It's the Love Shack. Oh my gosh.
Here we go.
Oh!
Hold your breath.
I thought it was lit red, but it's the lights from the car. I've been in the Lincoln Tunnel in New York.
This looks so awesome.
Tunnel of love.
Look at that lady's purse. It's all sequins. I'm just going to watch this for this lady when she passes by. She got an awesome purse in there. I got to get a video of it. It's all sparkly with sparkles on it. Look, we're going up the hill in the tunnel. I've never seen a tunnel where it goes up the hill.
Sparkles.
Look at it. Goes up the hill. It's going up now.
Oh, my gosh.
This guy's got a bedpan. You look at some people's cars, and they got the weirdest stuff. The guy had a bedpan in his car.
It's windy.
Is it?
It's wanting to blow me all over the place.
Editing a video while Mike is driving. I'm trying to get caught up. Okay. In my fence. Oh, we gotta get propane.
We get propane?
We're on the yellow already today. I just remembered.
We need the sugar.
So it's 2:30 in the afternoon, and we pulled up to the Mobile Walmart, and we just called the manager, and she said it was okay because we looked at the camp and RV app, and it said that some people say that you don't, some people said that you could. She said that we could park as long as we're towards the Lowe's, and that right there is the Lowe's, so we're all the way at the end of the parking lot at the Walmart.
Towards the Lowe's,
yeah. So we should be good here for one night at Walmart, and hopefully they have WiFi here. Let's see if they have WiFi. Okay, guys, so it's been a real problem challenge again. This morning I woke up and there's no propane. The refrigerator's at 60, and it's raining cats and dogs here right now. And there's such huge puddle right here where we're parked, and the generator was gonna get wet in the flood. So me and Christian have to get up and move the generator over, but there's really not a lot of space where we're at. So I'm on my way to go get the propane right now. Gotta walk all the way over there to the Murphy. They have a cage over there with some propane. Okay, guys, what a problem. We pulled out of the Walmart with no breakfast this morning. Crazy looking for propane everywhere in this part of Alabama that we're at. We're in Mobile. Originally, Mike, when we pulled up yesterday, I told him about the propane, and he said, oh, don't worry about it because Walmart will exchange your tanks. And I just forgot about it. I really did. I forgot about it. I should have been on it that night. When the refrigerator died out this morning, Christian and I went out in the rain at a Murphy gas station, at the Lowe's, at the Walmart. And all that they have is 15-gallon tanks, and I'm not trading in a 20-gallon for a 15-gallon. That's just not going to happen. So I woke Mike up, and I said, we got to get out of here. And we took off really early in the morning, and we went to Home Depot. We went to a couple of places that we called, and they said they do exchange the 20 pounds. So just so you know, these are just employees that don't know the difference between 15 and 20. They don't have it at Home Depot. They don't have it at Lowe's, at least not in Alabama. And I know in Florida they don't either. It's not the common size. So finally I called a couple of RV parks. One of them, well, was 4 miles away, was out. And then I called Johnny's RV. Then I looked it up in my GPS, and it was about 11 miles away. So we drove out here. The problem is that it's raining today and it's thundering. So when we pulled up here to get the propane, she said to us, you can't get propane when it's thundering because it's the law. They're not allowed to pump it out. So they were kind enough to let us into this very unleveled spot. We backed in to the spot, and she let me have 30 amp service for a while until we can kind of wait out the weather and see if we can fill up. We haven't heard it thundery since this morning, so I don't know what's wrong. Mike just went in there and asked her if they can do it now because it hasn't been lightning or thundering for a while. But she said she has to call first. We are so unleveled. I mean, we're pretty much like this. That's how bad it is. I mean, you walk in here and you want to tilt over. That's how bad this site is, I guess, because it's near the office. And we had to pull in way to the back because we're not going to be unhitching. So I'm just thankful that at least I'm hooked up right now to electric. And I just came in here and I took a chamois and I wiped off all of the ice that's been melting in the refrigerator, because if that refreezes, all that water as it defrosted, if all that water defrosts, it's going to be like chunks of ice in my refrigerator. So I picked it up with the chamois, and now it's nice and dry in there, and now it's coming back up to temperature. The cooler bag in here, it's got all my stuff in there. So I'm just going to wait a while till that gets up to temperature and then take the stuff out once I know we're going to get the propane tanks filled. So we'll see how it goes. Yeah,
it's really bad out.
I heard thunder out in the distance.
They're not going to do it. They're
no,
so long.
They're not going to do it.
So what are we going to do? And
we're
can't even
have to take off.
Where else are we going to go?
What?
Where else are we going to go? What do they charge for this park? Do we even know?
No, I mean, we don't want to give them any business. That's ridiculous.
Why? I don't understand why she's being nice and she's letting us hook up over here. How is that not nice?
Probably because she wants us to stay here.
No.
Okay, guys, so we're still here at this park that she's allowing us to stay here for a while. Probably been here for about 30 minutes, and it looks like it's still bad out. So, you know, these are things that happen on the road. It was our fault because we let the propane run too low, and I feel really thankful that she's giving us some free hookup for a little while here. But it may just go that we may just have to stay here if the weather stays like this, because by law they're not allowed to put propane in a tank when it's thundering out and there's lightning. So right now we are at a tilt in this spot, which is not level. So eventually, if I have to stay here overnight, I'll get a better spot. But she is giving us electric, so we have our air conditioner on, and I'm actually making breakfast here because of our stuff. Our refrigerator is still getting up to temperature. It's still, the freezer is still in the 40s. So it's more like in the 50s going to the 40s. So I'm waiting to put the stuff in there. And right now I'm making breakfast for everybody since we are hooked up to electric. I did offer to give her $5 for, you know, for an hour or two. And she said no, she'd let us do it. So that was nice of her. So after breakfast, what I'll go inside and ask her what the rates are, what they charge, just in case we do have to spend the night here. It might just be something that we're going to have to do. And these are things that are going to happen on the road. This is RV life. You know, things happen, and you just have to, you know, you just have to resolve your problems.
Oh my gosh. It's so unleveled there.
So, Mom, while they fill up the propane, we got to check up the tires.
No, we're going to do that. We're going to do the tires here. We couldn't do that in the over there where it's up level.
I mean, it's not level here, but it's at least the trailer's not tilting.
Okay, there's our propane. Just put your emergency brake on because we're on a hill and we got all that weight behind us.
Yeah, that always helps. We don't want the thing sliding back.
Finally pulling out of Johnny's RV, and a big shout out to Johnny's, what's it called? Johnny's RV Resort in Theadore, Alabama, because the girl at the front, she was really nice. She did a lot of nice things for us, and she finally filled up the propane because the skies are turning blue and we don't hear the thunder anymore. So she filled up both of our tanks for $16, I think, each tank? I think so, $16.
Yep, $16 each.
$16 each tank, which was a great price.
So we got both of them filled. We wouldn't need propane for a long time. But I was telling Mike that we have to keep our eyes. When one tank is empty, then we have to make sure that the other one gets full right away.
You see how cloudy it is out here? We're not able to get a fully charged on the batteries, and that's a bad thing because we're heading up north and we're going to get a lot of days like that.
We also have to sit down tonight and estimate our route so we can order the battery charger for the solar so that our batteries are topped off whenever we're running the generator or whenever we are at an RV park. We always have batteries because if we would have been able to run our solar this morning, we would have been able to do that. Run the refrigerator for a while on that, so that would have been helpful, but we learned our lesson. So
our GPS is set to head north.
Hey guys, we are now in off-grid self-reliant RV. Subscribe to watch us on the road as we put this RV to the self-sustainable test. Don't forget to thumbs up if you enjoy the efforts we are putting out. As always, thanks for watching.